All right, good Sunday morning. It's 10:45. Meteorologist Scott Sumner here with you. I'm doing a Facebook Live because we do have a tornado watch in effect until 6 p.m. for a good chunk of the viewing area. That does mean from basically the Savannah River, point south of there, to the Altahama River. I'll show you that here with a map quite nicely. We'll zoom in just a little bit, and you'll be able to see what I'm talking about. All this area that's shaded in red, right in through here from Savannah, through Sylvania, down to Vidalia, and then just north of Jessup, right along the coastline. This area is under a tornado watch until 6 p.m. again. We've got this line with another line of storms later this afternoon with the actual cold front itself. This has been racing towards the east at roughly 40 miles an hour, so we're seeing a little more activity than expected a little earlier by a couple of hours from what the forecast models had showed last night. Now, you'll notice there is these little dots there on the map. That does indicate that there's some lightning with that, so a lot of thunder and lightning associated with it. As a matter of fact, these yellow outlines are severe thunderstorm warnings, and that is in effect for Jeff Davis County. Jeff Davis County has a severe thunderstorm warning in effect here, and we'll get the exact time on that as I go to my board here. We'll take a look here. Okay, that comes through. Okay, there we go. Severe thunderstorm warning. Quite a bit of stuff that's coming through, so bear with me. But bottom line here is this warning was posted or came out just a short time ago, and it looks like that is going to be, let's see here, so 11:15, got it. Had to check the board. So we've got about another, 25 minutes on that severe thunderstorm warning. Hello, everyone. The Savannah area is going to be under the gun here, and we're under Savannah and the surrounding area, I should say, are under a tornado watch until 6 p.m. So wide view, let me just put out a wide view here. You'll be saying, well, my goodness, all this one line and that's it? No, we have a cold front that is actually further west than this initial line that you see here on Storm Tracker Radar Network that will be moving across the region as we go throughout the mid-afternoon. Yes, Kim, very gusty winds will be seen. Probably a wind advisory will be issued throughout the entire area for today. Regardless of any thunderstorms, there'll be some strong winds across the region as we go throughout the afternoon until this cold front really works its way past and out to sea. We'll still have winds behind the system, but overall, the highest winds will be seen out ahead of the cold front itself. As far as rain is concerned, Tanetta, we're looking at a good 1 inch, I think, a quick 1 inch of rain with it. Because it's fast moving, I don't think we're going to see really too much in the way of any flooding, although your typical low-lying areas that are prone to flood, I wouldn't be surprised to see those quickly get flooded. But again, that's an area, and those are areas that are limited. It's not a widespread flooding situation. It's a more of a very localized, highly localized situation where you may get some individual areas that are flooded out. Again, tornado watch is what you got to know and be aware of is in effect for Screven County, Effingham County, Chatham County. That includes Bullock, Bryan, Liberty County, Long County, McIntosh County, Tatnall and Evans, as well as Candler, and as well as Montgomery and Toombs. Those areas, everything north of the Altahama River and south of the Savannah River, wedged right in the middle of our viewing area where the highest population is under a tornado watch until 6 p.m. Now, what that means is that tornadoes are possible to form in this area during this time frame. Now, also notice there are some yellow boxes here. Those are individual sections that have severe thunderstorm warnings in effect across the area. So as a result, we could have maybe no tornado warnings, but we could certainly have some severe thunderstorm warnings. So we've got the gamut of weather that is going to occur today, and eventually we'll see a much cooler day tomorrow due to the fact that this front will be moving on through here. Notice, too, there's quite a bit of cloudiness across the area, which is hopefully going to limit somewhat some of the instability that would be in the atmosphere as opposed to having full sunshine seen before the front and before this arrives in the area. So maybe that might be a little bit of a limiting or mitigating factor towards some of the severity of this line as it continues to push to the east-northeast. But again, what I am seeing is the bowing effect here, and this is over the last hour. Let's take it back just a couple of hours and resume the initial motion of it. You can see, again, you can see the kind of the twisting of those storms, that line out ahead of the cold front. Cold front's still back off to the west at this point in time, so we'll watch that as well before and after this initial line comes through. So again, we've got several hours of storms to move through here before we actually get some clearing across the region. All right, so to reiterate, we do have tornado watch in effect, severe thunderstorm warnings in effect. Individual cells are producing those severe thunderstorms. And a lot of lightning associated with this particular line. This is headed towards Alma and Blackshear. And let's switch modes here for you. What I'll do, let's get you a different look here. That's just the general far view. I want to get you a different little close-in inspection of what we see. Okay, that's just a different look here. And let's see, just getting it. Okay. Okay, so again, here we are, a little closer to home. Here's the severe thunderstorm warnings that affect part of Jeff Davis County until 11:15. Alma, Blackshear, you'll be in the path of this line as it continues to move out from the southwest to the northeast. And then eventually Jessup and Baxley as we move into Wayne County and also into Appling County as well. Again, some heavy downpours with this as it moves forward. And let's see here, get an idea, maybe some rain rates with this. Whoops. Well, we'll stick back with the radar here. Okay, so there we go. Severe thunderstorm warning down towards Homerville, Axton, Ambrose area. All of this, again, moving up towards the Alma area. See the lightning associated with that? So some heavy downpours and lightning across the region. We'll be watching for winds to see if there's any wind damage coming out. And yeah, that will be exactly. I'm checking a couple of things here as we speak to see what's coming across the wires. We're tied into the National Weather Service and live chat, seeing if there's anything going on. Okay, so again, Ambrose, south of Ambrose, and part of Ambrose actually is under severe thunderstorm warning, and that's going to be moving up in towards the Baxley, Alma, Blackshear area. So I wouldn't be surprised if the severe thunderstorm warning continues into those areas, which this severe thunderstorm warning here goes to 11:15 for Coffee in Jeff Davis County, and then most likely that would be extended if it holds its strength to get into both Bacon and Appling County. Now elsewhere, things are quiet. If you're living in Springfield, Statesboro, Sylvania, Hampton, all of the low country right now, not seeing much of anything, but again, we do have a tornado watch in effect for most of the area, which is going to be in effect until 6 p.m. Once we get to 6, 7 o'clock tonight, the threat of the storms will start to wind down as the actual cold front moves off the coast. All right, Beaufort. Beaufort right now is quiet, but the timing on Beaufort, let me switch systems here. Let me do this. Again, bear with me here. Timing for Beaufort is most likely going to be around 4 or 5 o'clock with the actual cold front itself as it moves through. That's when we'll most likely see the greatest winds at that point in time, the heaviest rain, and the most severe weather. Windy in Springfield, Meg, yes, it'll be windy all day. Lindsay, yes, keep an eye on the weather there. Guys, Hazelhurst, Stephanie, you'll be getting into some stronger storms here probably within the next 40, 45 minutes. Elijah Juan, expected to hit the Savannah metro area. It looks like one line comes through around 2 or 3, with the actual front moving through sometime around 5 or 6. So 2 to 3 for one time frame and about 5 to 6 for another. Tanya, let's see here. Jessup, Blue Luisi, Hinesville, that area probably around 11, well, no, check that, about 12. Around 12, 12:30, somewhere in that time frame. Again, so we're watching this line, initial line, which is producing some strong to severe thunderstorms across the area. You see quite a bit of lightning associated with this. And again, this is going to go until 11:15, this particular line of storms. But then I would expect that to continue. Right now, I don't see any sort of drop-off with the severe thunderstorm warnings. In effect, as they continue to push off to the northeast. Again, this is the first line of two different separate lines that could produce strong to severe weather. And again, we're under a tornado watch, which means conditions are favorable for tornado formation. Doesn't mean it's going to happen, but conditions are favorable for tornadoes to form due to the low-level and upper-level wind fields. And as a result, we'll have to watch that. But right now, I'm watching this line of storms that's moving through, again, Jeff Davis County will be moving through there in the next 20 minutes or so. See if we have any more questions across the region. Also, see. Right, Jacksonville continues a severe thunderstorm warning for Jeff Davis County. 60-mile-an-hour winds potential with this. Torrential rainfall as well, which may lead to flash flooding. So we'll watch that closely here. It's moving east-northeast at 50 miles an hour, so it's really, really moving across the region. See if we get some more questions coming in. Again, I'm checking the board to see. Okay, yeah, Elijah, one. I am here. I'm just checking the board just to see if anything new is coming across the National Weather Service chat. So if I'm quiet just for a second, that's what I'm doing, checking graphics while I'm got you on guys online here. Okay.
You on this computer?
I am not on this computer. I could switch us out. Oh, that? No, I'm not on that.
I'm going to get on this one.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, with me, morning meteorologist Jonathan Myers. We're going to tag team and help you out this morning and this afternoon with regards to this severe situation, potential severe situation across the area. Again, we have a tornado watch in effect until 6 p.m. for really all of or most of southeastern Georgia, south of the Savannah River line, north of the Altahama River, which is basically north of Jessup and north of Appling and north of Bacon counties, north of Wayne County, north of Pierce County. I've got a lot of things. Thank you for Jessup. Okay, not a problem. Cooler weather, Stephanie, will be coming in here tomorrow and will be with us into early on Tuesday. Hilton Head, Francis, storms will be impacting, potentially impacting Hilton Head, I would think somewhere around 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and then another line potentially around 6 to 7 for Hilton Head. Wanda in Liberty County, we're looking at a time frame for Liberty, roughly 1 to 2, somewhere in that time frame, a bit of a break, and then another round coming in at 3:30 till about 6. Wilmington Island is the same as Savannah. We're looking at probably a 3 to 4, and then another round to come through about 5 to 6. Sarah in Pooler. Pooler is very much like Savannah, so I would also say the same thing, about 3 to 4, and then about 5 to 6. No problem, Wanda, on Liberty County. Hampton County. Hampton County is going to be a little bit later. We'll have some rain coming through Hampton County, most likely in the afternoon. One batch of rain moving through Hampton County. Looking at this, somewhere around 3:30. And then continuing to potentially 8 o'clock for Hampton County. Okay, guys, let me step away for 1 second here. And I just got to talk to Jonathan Myers quickly, and then I'll be back. I'm leaving the radar up again. Severe thunderstorm warning in effect till 11:15 for parts of Jeff Davis County, the western portion of the county, a general tornado watch in effect, and I'll be right back. All right, I'm back with you here. I am going to just do a couple of fixes here, switch out a couple of different things. I will be back with you here, so I'm going to stop streaming for a short amount of time. What you need to know, though, is certainly be aware that there is a tornado watch in effect for areas, all of Chatham County, Effingham County, Screven County. So really from the Savannah River down to the Altahama River, which takes you down to McIntosh, Long, Tatnall, Montgomery and Toombs County. There is a watch, tornado watch in effect till 6 p.m. this evening. I will be back. I will continue to do a Facebook Live, but I'm going to stop here for the moment, and I will be back in just a short amount of time.